think we can start getting ready. I'm Erin. This is Bar. For my improvised bar, I'm going to be using a countertop and the back of a chair. You guys can use tables, backs of couches, whatever works for you. I'm going to be using light weights, about 2 to 3 pounds. If you don't have hand weights, you can use canned goods, bottles of water, bottles of wine, whatever you have on hand. And at the end, I'm going to be going to a mat, but if you just have a blanket at home, that works great too. So when you have everything and you're ready, we're going to get started at our improvised bar. So we're going to start in first position, heels together, toes apart, shoulders stacked over your hips. We're just going to start finding a light plie, and then coming up on the balls of our feet. Taking this at your own pace. Really thinking about your knees, tracking over your second and third toe in that plie. Strong ankles on that releve. Start to speed that up. Finding that good form we're gonna be coming back to. Tailbone is tucked. 4 more right here. 3. Next time we're on the balls of our feet, we're gonna stay high and click those heels tight together. We have one leg. We're gonna start moving through those plies with our heels tight. Pressing those knees to the corners of the room. Nice. Really sinking low here. Making sure we're not hinging at the waist. Four more. Next one, we're going to stay low. Find a little hip hinge, side to side, like a windshield wiper. And we're staying low. Nothing is moving except those hips. Trying not to lean side to side. Can you come 1 inch lower? Add a little challenge. 8. Nice, you guys. 6. Four, stay low. It's easy to start having those legs straighten on you. Last one, and we're gonna stay low. Find that hold. Option to get a little balance practice here. But if that compromises your form, that's why the bar is here. Staying low. Can you come 1 inch lower? Strongest representation of the move here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, let those legs shake. 3, 2, 1. Nice job, you guys. Woo! All right, we're warm. That was quick. All right, coming back to that first position, we're going to start stepping this leg wide. Still thinking about those knees, tracking over your second and third toe, making this a nice big movement. Really sinking low. Booty coming just an inch or two above knee height. And those shoulders are staying stacked over your hips here. How big can you make this movement? Letting your whole body warm up here. 4 more. Dragging that toe in, using your inner thighs. Next one, we're gonna stay wide, rotate towards the bar in a low lunge, back wide, and in. Really think about a strong bend in both knees when you're in that lunge. Back knee just a couple inches off the ground. Work through this at your own pace. You wanna speed this up, get a little cardio. Take your time, really focus on the strength. whatever works for your body. Four more here. Really bending both those legs. Staying low the whole time. Next one, we're gonna stay in that lunge. Hinging over onto our bar, lifting that back leg. Soft front knee. Tap, lift. Tap, lift. Making sure you're hinged over. If you're upright, you're gonna be feeling this in your lower back. And we want that work in our booty. Soft supporting knee. Foot not coming above hip height. Hips are staying square to the bar in front of you. Nice. Point that toe. Eight. Nice, you guys. Four more. Really working with control. Two. Next one, we're gonna keep that leg lifted. Slight cross behind your supporting leg, right back to center. So from the back. Hips are staying square, and it's just a light cross, right back to center. Get in the side of that booty. Don't start locking out that supporting knee. Keeping it nice and soft. Nice, you guys. Eight. Really working with control. Four more, you're almost there. Next time that leg's lifted, we're gonna keep it high. Little pulses. Promise you get a stretch after this. Super small, 1 inch. Focusing on that booty, really feeling it in your supporting leg. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Nice job, stand up. It feels good to take this foot over for a little figure four stretch, go for it. Walk out those hips. And we're gonna stay facing our bar. We're gonna forearms distance, and our feet are about hip distance apart. So we're gonna come up on the balls of our feet, and we're gonna press our knees forward. So our booty's in line with our heels, shoulders stacked over your hips. We're just gonna sink low and pulse. Super low. Making sure those knees are staying forward. It's kind of easy to start sitting back here. That takes all the fun out of it. Nice, you guys. Can you come 1 inch lower here? Eight more pulses and we're gonna stay low. Six, five, four, three, two. Keep those heels up, stay low. And we're just gonna alternate, lifting one heel, then the other. But we're staying low here. Nothing is moving except those heels. Woo. Keep those shoulders over your hips. I can see myself leaning forward. Eight. You're almost there. Burn it out. Five. Four. Three. Two. Both come up. Final hold. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Nice job. Woo. That is a good burn. I will feel that tomorrow. All right, if you want to take a little stretch here, go for it. All right, and we're gonna come to the other side. So if you're staying at one bar, you'll just be this way. And I'm gonna scoot over here so I'm not facing the back. Coming back to that first position, heels together, toes apart. Just find that light plie, releve. focusing on form here. So that when the moves get a little more dynamic and difficult, we remember that good form to come back to. Tucking our tailbone, strong ankles. Four more. Nice knees tracking over that second and third toe. On the next one, we're gonna come up on the balls of our feet. Heels are gonna click together tight, like we have one leg. Bend, plie. Nice, you guys. Make sure you're not sticking out your booty. Squeezing those legs when you come up. Really feeling your inner thighs work here. Four. Three. Two. Next one, we're gonna stay low. Find those hips. Nothing is moving except your hips here. Like a windshield wiper, just swiping back and forth. Can you come 1 inch lower here? Eight. Nice, you guys. It's okay if those legs are shaking. That's the change happening. Two. Next one, we're gonna hold low. Finding that final balance, that strongest representation of the move. Woo! Five, four, three, come 1 inch lower. Two, one, nice job. Ooh. All right, you guys walk it out. Coming back to that first position, this leg is gonna step wide. Pointing that toe, dragging it across the floor, using your inner thighs. If you don't like circling that arm, option to have it right here on your hip. How big can you make this move? How low can that booty come? Nice, you guys. Four more here. Sinking low. Next one, we're gonna stay wide. Rotate that low lunge. Back open and in. Staying low the whole time. Really equal bend. Strong bend in both those knees on the lunge. Front knee not coming over your toes. Back knee coming straight down. This is a great one to speed up. If you want to really bring your heart rate up, get a little cardio at the bar. Nice, you guys. Four more here. Two. Next time we're in that lunge, we're gonna find that lunge, hinging over. Really making sure you're hinged over enough that you're not feeling this in your lower back. Hips square to the bar, lift and lower. Nice soft supporting knee. Pointing that working toe. Working with control. We don't want to be kicking that leg using momentum. We're going to be using our booty to place that foot right where we want it to go. Thinking about your booty doing the work here. If you are feeling this in your lower back, hinge forward more
Or don't bring that leg quite as high. Nice, you guys. Hip staying square. Four more. Two. Next one, we're gonna leave that foot high. Slight cross behind the supporting leg. Right back to center. Hips are staying square. Try not to open up that hip as we make that cross. Nice, you guys. Work with control here. Four more. Three. Two. Next one, we're gonna keep that foot high. Little pulses. Burn it out. You get a stretch after this, I promise. Eight. Seven, six, five, four, three, keep it up there, two, one, nice job, woo, stand up, if you want to take that little figure four stretch, lock out those hips, you earned it, all right, we are going to grab our weights, and again, if you don't have weights, water bottles, cans, bottles of wine, whatever works for you. Coming back to that first position, heels together, toes apart. Coming up on the balls of our feet. And we're gonna click those heels together, just like at the bar. Arms are gonna come out to goalpost. So your elbows in line with your shoulder. And as we bend our knees, our arms are gonna come forward. And then overhead. Making sure those weights are just slightly in front of your body. You should be able to see them out of your peripheral vision. Shoulders are down, core is engaged. Always an option to take out the legs and just focus on the arms at any point. I get it, you've done a lot of pliés. If you're plié'd out, you can just do these arms. You guys. Four more here. Two. On this next one, we're gonna come back to that goal post. And we're going to bring our elbows in tight as we bend. Then up to a V. Palms are facing forward. Really focusing on that. Pulling those elbows in tight to your side. Nice, you guys. Weight staying just in front of you. Four more here. Don't let those shoulders creep up. Two. Next time, we're tight in. Little pulses. Squeezing those elbows. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two, one, nice job. Roll out those shoulders. Making sure no one's like, I can't see anything. All right. So we're gonna keep those weights in our hand. This leg is gonna come back in a curtsy lunge. So feet are about a foot distance apart. Both feet are turned out. Equal bend, bicep curl. Step that foot wide. Weight staying below shoulder height. Other foot comes back in that curtsy lunge. Elbows tight at your side on that bicep curl. Really thinking about that weight being evenly distributed between those legs in that curtsy lunge. Nice, you guys, sink it low. Four more. Then we're gonna add on. Three. Two. Next one, option to add on. When we're wide, flip over, flip back. Bicep curl. If you don't like that little flip on your shoulders, you can just stick with the original extension. Nice, you guys. Almost there. Work it at your own pace. Nice, you guys. One more after this. Finish it. Last bicep curl. Nice, you guys. Whew. Roll out those shoulders. You got a little drink of water. We're gonna bring feet parallel. Come on, hip distance apart. We're gonna find a little bend in the knees and a little hinge at the waist. Palms are facing one another. And as we bring this arm back for a row, we're gonna tap this foot to the side. So like that. Switch. On those rows, the elbow's coming straight back. Shoulders are staying square to the front. Keeping a nice bend in those knees. Chest is staying lifted. Soft tap to the side. Toe is barely touching. When you've got it, you can speed that up. You can also float that leg at the side, not setting the toe down, and that'll add a little challenge. Elbow coming straight back. Speed it up if you want a little more cardio. Staying low. Nice. Arms brushing your side on that row. Nice, you guys. Four more. Three. Two, next one, we're gonna stay with that bend. Both elbows come back, arms extend, bend. Getting those triceps. Nothing is working or moving from the elbows up. Those elbows are high and tight to your side. And you're thinking about those triceps as we work them. Really moving with control here. Don't let those elbows start opening them up. Keep them tight there. Eight. Super controlled. No momentum here. No swinging. Four more and we pulse. Two. Next one. Leave those arms extended. Little pulses. Super small. Burn out the back of those arms. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Nice job, you guys. Whew. All right. We are gonna grab our mats. This is the fun part. All right. Nope. sure I'm in the screen. All right, keep your weights beside you. Might use them for some of our core moves here. And we're gonna come out to a plank. Hands just under your shoulders, a little wide. And we're gonna alternate arms tapping a shoulder and finding that push-up. Chest coming to elbow height. Tap, tap, push up. You want this to be on your knees? Awesome option. Tap, tap, push up. Whatever works for your body. Trying not to have that upper body rock. I know it's hard. Nice, you guys. Four more, wherever you are. Keeping that long posterior chain. Don't let that head sink down. Last one. Nice, you guys. Knees come down. Find that stretch. Woo, all right. Arms feel good. All right, we're gonna come down to our side. And we're gonna bring our legs in front of us like we're an uppercase L. So your legs are directly in front of you. If you're facing me, I'd be able to see the bottoms of your feet. And you can be right here, or you can come all the way down. And that nice uppercase L with our body. And we're gonna lift that upper leg and bring it to hover. Not closing our legs fully. Just a nice hover there. Nice, keeping everything engaged. Making sure that leg is staying in front of you. It's not coming out here. It's just straight in front. I got this one from Natasha, and it hurts really badly, so if you want to complain to her, go for it. It's a tough one. But so good. Nice. Staying on your side, making sure you're not rolling with that leg. Four more. Not closing those legs, bringing it to hover. Two. Next time we're gonna leave it open. Little presses back. Super small here. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Bring it back to hover, don't close them. And we're gonna crunch this knee into the same shoulder, keeping that hover. So the knee is coming to the same shoulder, crunching it in. Nice, now's when it starts to really feel good. Woo, four more. Three, two. Next time it's extended, we have one final move. We're gonna turn it so your toes are facing down, heel is facing up, and we're gonna lift with that heel. So that knee is turned in towards the floor. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Oh my gosh, that kills me. All right, you wanna bring that leg over. Give that hip a few little hits. For some reason, that makes it feel better, I think. All right, we're gonna come to a seated position. Feet are extended, toes touching the ground, and we're leaned back, finding that core engagement. If this feels really good and you feel that core engagement, it's a great place to be. You want to start practicing a little balance. You want to start adding a little movement. If all of that feels really secure, you can open and close. And you can work between these movements, doing a few right here, going back to those taps, whatever works for your body.
giving that booty a quick reprieve before we move on to the other side. Nice, you guys. Four more wherever you are. Two, last one. Nice job, you guys. All right, we're gonna come on to the other side. Again, making that uppercase L with your body. So feet directly in front of you. To be able to see the soles of your feet. And then bringing that top leg to that hover. From here on out, those legs shouldn't touch. So that hover, I'm gonna lift straight up and lower. Hips are staying square to the front. Rise. Try not to open that hip as you open that leg. I know it's challenging. I can feel myself doing it. Nice, you guys. Four more. Next one, we're gonna keep that leg open. Little presses back. Small. Just a few inches here. This is when you really start to feel it. Eight, seven, four, two, one. Bring that leg down to hover, don't close it. And we're gonna bring that knee to the same shoulder, crunching it in. Remember, those legs are not touching. Crunch. Knee to the same shoulder. You're almost there. Only one more move after this, and you get that nice booty stretch. Four more. Really bring that knee in. Two. Next time that leg is extended, toes point down, heel up, little pulses. Knee is facing the floor. Super small. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Woo! Nice job. Bring that leg over. Shake it out. Good job, you guys. All right, we're gonna come onto our back, a little bit more core. So option to use a weight for this one, but you don't have to. You're using a weight, the weight's gonna be just above your forehead, toes are on the ground, and we're gonna bring that, we're gonna crunch towards our knees. So finding a little C crunch, right back down, toes tap. Making sure our lower back is staying pressed into the mat. We're gonna be arching here. If you want extra challenge, extend those legs out a little bit further. The longer the lever, the harder the workload will be. Really crunching in here. Nice, you guys. Four more here. Three. Two. Next one, we're gonna stay crunched. Holding that crunch, we're gonna extend in a shootout. Making sure that lower back stays pressed in. If you don't like having your head, neck, and shoulders off the ground, you can set them down and just do the leg extension. And you'll still get that lower core work. Nice, you guys. One. Nice job.
Whew, you can set that weight down. Take a nice long stretch. One more, a little bit of core work, and then we're all done.
So arms are gonna come into a T. In line with your shoulders. Knees in line with your hips. And we're just gonna lean, making sure both shoulders are staying pressed into the mat. Using those obliques here. You shift side to side. Just like on the last one, if you want a little extra challenge, extend those legs a little further out. Making sure that your shoulders are not lifting. Nice, you guys. Using that side body here. Four more. Okay, coming onto your back, bringing that right knee into your chest, left leg stays long, give me a little hug. You can circle it. Changing direction. And that knee is going to cross over to the other side. Finding that nice lower back stretch, looking opposite direction. When you're ready, switching legs. Circling. Other way. That leg's gonna cross over. Looking opposite. And when you're ready, we're gonna come up to a sitting position. Legs extend long in front of you, hinging at the waist. We're gonna pop up to a little yoga froggy squat. If it feels good, you can use your elbows to press your knees out, get a little extra stretch there. Add a little movement, whatever feels good. Our legs are gonna extend, folding over at the waist. Slowly rolling up one vertebrae at a time. I'm finding that final big breath in. Thank you guys so much. I will be back here Thursday at 9:30.